Given the high rate of all forms of violence perpetrated against children and teens, some children may feel comfortable to speak out, while others may not feel safe disclosing their experiences, yet give clues if empowered. The Child Protection Manager at Child Fund International, Timothy Opobo, reveals that many children are being abused, yet they have no avenues for reporting these cases.
There are scenarios where, I'll give you an example of a girl who was actually being sexually abused by the father. And she was being, her and her sister were being abused. And when she got the courage to report this abuse, the family had decided that this issue should be settled within. But at that time, we got information through a toll-free line that we were manning, that this child, this was happening. And when we went and got information, we found that it was actually true, and the case was open. But the children had actually decided they will not testify because they were going to be excommunicated. He said, how can you testify against your father?
Because of stigma, children continue to suffer in silence, as most perpetrators will tell the child to keep the abuse a secret.
I think one of the major issues that has to be addressed is confidence and self-awareness for these children. For example, children need to be told that the old person is never right all the time, that they also make errors, just like a kid would do so, an old person does so always. So this empowers them to know that when someone does something, it's never, if it's wrong, it's wrong. It can't be a right thing because it's been done by an old person. This will help them speak out and also be free about themselves and about all other people around them.
The empowerment is done by the children. So we tell them, hey, look, you have an opportunity or you have a talent you didn't know about. Can you write? Yes. So our skill is mainly encouraging children to write what they go through.
What is more worrying, many parents are not aware of rights and forms of violence against children, as many think that they are just disciplining their children. Some parents do not always talk to their children about body safety early enough.
Rights encompass so many perspectives. For example, children have a right to be heard, whatever they say. Children have a right to education. Children have a right to health care. And children have the right to their basic needs for proper growth.
Experts suggest that one should reinforce a child's assertiveness, like letting them know that their opinions are honored, as this improves a child's self-esteem, thereby enabling him or her to speak up when they face abuse.
Okay, we talk to these children as we go out to the schools and encourage them to be their own journalists or their own storytellers, because the moment you tell a story, it's improving your self-esteem.
We must educate and sensitize communities, but even the children themselves, on these existing laws. They must know what the law says. We must resource the duty bearers, these police officers, the magistrates, with the content in the law. I can tell you authoritatively that many of them are ignorant. They don't know what these laws are saying. The laws are there, but they don't know what the laws are saying. So we must do that, and we must empower the children themselves.
The Violence Against Children report suggests that education and life skills should be adopted to increase child participation, empowerment, and instilling in children the confidence to resist and or to speak up regarding experiences of violence against them. UNICEF, in partnership with Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development, launched a toll-free helpline that members of the public can use to report cases of violence and abuse against children. The toll-free number is 116. One can also send an SMS on 8338 for any child abuse-related information. This report was compiled by Dennis Wonyala for Urban TV.